So this is the HTC first running Facebook Home, or I think we just call it Home. So it says, it's very subtle on the back, it says HTC, there's the Facebook Home logo, and it's on AT&T, camera up there, kind of a matte, kind of nice, you know, it's a good size phone, I think, it's not too big, like a lot of, well anyways, I like the size of the phone. So this is what you see when you turn the phone on. It's kind of like the lock screen, and it's also your home screen. So when you turn it on, you see the time, because that's often the first thing you do when you turn your phone on. And then it will automatically go through stories, in your cover feed. So this is a Mac Tyler Chase profile picture. I can see somebody else posted that they were at the announcement event. And this is what a status looks like. So there's a few things we show. There are photo posts, status updates, link shares, when somebody shares a link. Yeah, I think that's about it. And if you like something, you can double tap to like it. Or can you? Oh, I can't like that because it's a privacy thing. I can like this one because you can see the like comment buttons are there. I could also see who else liked or commented on the story by tapping that. And then I can see that. I can also swipe it down and dismiss. So that's cover feed. You can also go see your other apps. So it's also an app launcher. These are my bookmarks, apps that I particularly care about. If I want to see all the apps I have on my device, I can swipe over to the left and see an alphabetical list over there. Also, when I hold in my profile pic, I see Messenger and the previous app that I was in. And actually, I got some notifications from my friend Elizabeth, who commented on my stuff. If I want, I could just double tap it to open that notification, or I could swipe them away if I wanted to like that. Another feature that I think is really awesome is in Messenger, we have this new thing called Chat Ads. So if by some miracle Elizabeth sends me a message, I actually see a chat ad appear on the screen. And this is really awesome because with chat heads, your friend is with you on your phone wherever you are. So right now, I'm on cover feed. But if I was in another app, say Instagram, you'll see my friend Elizabeth's profile picture is still there. And it shows how many messages are on mine right now. So this is really cool. I can be on Instagram, and if I want, I can tap the chat ad and carry on a conversation with my friend. Now, the chat ad is on the screen at all times, so we want to make sure that it's not too in the way. So if you want, you can drag the chat ad to another part of the screen. You can also fling it around, which is pretty fun. So that's a kind of quick way to do it. So I could easily type a message. I would say I can't spell very well. And go back to Instagram. Also, if you want to dismiss the conversation, you can drag up the thread view like that. What's also really cool is that you can carry on multiple conversations at once. So, as you saw there, there's a way to actually bring up a chat ad for a conversation if you really want the person to be on the screen. And now in this case, I have these two conversations, which I can drag around. It's kind of fun. And if I expand that, you see I have now both persons' profile picture at the top. I can switch between them pretty quickly. I can also reorder them. So if I want somebody else to be on the top of the stack, I can drag the chat heads like that. And you'll notice it's actually very smooth and performant. We spend a lot of time making sure the performance is going to be really good because this is a really different thing. When you're a feature over any app on the device, you really want to make sure that it's going to be smooth, performant, and not annoying. Like we really care to make sure that people are really going to like this feature. And when you're done with the conversation, you can drag it to the bottom, see that X, or if you're done with all of them, you can kind of fling them off to the post like that. I think those are some of the main features that I'm particularly excited about for Home. And on the HTC One, HTC First, of course. Yeah.